Hi, hello, my name is Sailor Starbones, and welcome to the video. First, I'd like to thank my Patreons, which are Jackal, Punk Bunny, Leafpool, and Monitor, and anyone else who would like to join. At as little as £1 a month, you have access to basically everything, especially videos like these, and more to come, about a week earlier than everyone else. So there we go. On to the video. This is the first time I've actually had an idea for the name for the creatures that I've been making. This is the only one so far that has a name, which is a Needle Nose Hippocampus, but you are also welcome to give me a better idea as well as draw it if you'd like, because it is cute. And I did make mine really tiny. I didn't make it super tiny. I was thinking making it hummingbird size, but I was like, no, I'm gonna like middle ground it just a little, so it's like between the size of a hummingbird and a miniature donkey or pygmy donkey. But I also used a leopard seal because it was the first one that I could actually draw, and I was planning on making more of them and different variations of them, but college crunch happened, which is great. It's not, but it's great, you know, like in the sarcastic state. But, you know, so I've been like now juggling the fact that I am now to make a children's story into either a book or comic, and I'm going to go for comic. And as much as my teacher doesn't want me to, because she keeps telling me I draw way too many animals, and every project I have done, I have not drawn a single animal by that much. Like, most of my things have been themed around plants, and she's like, you draw too many animals. Like, it's because you're furry. And I'm like, fuck it, bro. I might as well. So this one is gonna be anthros, and you can't do shit. Oh well, she tried. She tried, she did not win, because I actually don't draw animals that much. I have drawn way more people, monsters, and plants as of this year and last year, so there we go. And that's what's gonna happen, and that is definitely going up on my Patreon when it's done, because after this project is over, which is sometime in March, so as is the end of lockdown, apparently, which I also don't look forward to, because apparently everything's happening in March, which includes my birthday, which I don't look forward to in the case that lockdown gets, like, doubled downed upon, because I'm just like, I just wanna be around my friends so that I can have pizza and watch movies and not be sad inside my house for once in my life. But, you know, I might not be getting that. I'll be getting, hey, yeah, you know how, like, you accidentally ordered way too much soup base, and it's, like, not even separated into anything. It is just a full thing of, this is 8 servings in one packet, and you can't separate it out into separate 8 servings. You just have, like, a whole lot of fucking soup. Well, guess what, bitch? Fuck you. And I'm not looking forward to that. The soup thing is an entirely different problem, but, like, at the same time, it feels like the problem that I have to deal with altogether. I don't live with more than one person besides myself, so, you know, that soup is not going anywhere. And I'm still kind of upset at myself for that. But, like, not even, like, the upset. It's kind of like, God, this is so fucking ironic. Why did I do this? Kind of upset. Like, why? Why did I do this? It's because I didn't fucking read. I was looking at it, realized I couldn't read all of it because it was a wall of text. And as someone with ADHD plus dyslexia, it was like, well, this is words. This is more words. This is an extra fuck ton of words. Get fucking wrecked, Fry, because this is only words. You're only gonna get words, and just suck it up. Or I'm like, no, I don't want to. So I just ordered a fuck ton of soup that I'm just like, it's now sitting in my cupboard, waiting for the day that I have at least close to 8 people in my house. And that's not gonna happen. Especially with the fact that last year you could only have 6 people. And my friend group consists of 5 people, I think, give or take. I'll only get 6 people if lockdown lifts just as my birthday appears. But if not, I'm just like, well, I'll just play games with you guys, and hopefully I get to play games with all of them. I hope that I can play games with my boyfriends as well, because I'd like to play some games with them too. Because they're both in the States and I am not. I am in the UK. I'm really happy to be in the UK. But goddamn, my rights are going away as well, which, oof, politics, I don't want to go into that, so cut that. But yeah, it's gonna be fucking hellish. I don't look forward to it. But I kinda do, because if the chance of lockdown ending means that I get to watch movies with my friends and have pizza and just be general dips, which would be nice. But beyond that, if not, I guess we're playing Among Us or something, depending on what games they're up for, so that I can just, verbally cry about how they've murdered me in front of my children. Maybe I'll record it for once instead of being like, haha, what if I recorded this and then not? But it's a give or take situation, and it's gonna be a thing that's happening either way. Whether it's fun or not, who knows? It's just going to exist, and someone's gonna cry, and it's probably gonna be me. So, woo! But oh well. Other than the whole college fiasco and the lockdown series of unfortunate events and everything like that, there is excitement to the fact that I am getting mildly better at remembering to record videos. So yay, yay me! I'm not looking at my laptop and being like, oh yeah, I recorded a video, and then I look for it and realize I didn't actually record it. Because, like, last time I was recording a video to go up a little bit earlier this month, I opened the recording program and then I closed it while I was working. And then I was like, oh yeah, this video is gonna be pretty neat. And then I looked for it. Because I thought I recorded it, to realize, no, I did not record this. I just opened the program, turned it off, and continued with my art. Oh well, it's a thing that I did, it's a thing I regret, and it's a thing that I am going to learn from. I don't know what I'm going to learn, because I do not have the memory for it. But I'm gonna learn something, I guess, give or take. Learning things. The other things that I'm learning so far is to be nicer to myself. I am not often nice to myself, and if anyone should know, it's a lot of my friends and my boyfriends, both of them, know very well that I am not very nice to myself, and they definitely get very upset about it. But I'm working on it. I swear to God, I say this and then realize that I haven't had food yet. So, I swear to God, I'm gonna eat after this recording. But, get at me later. Get at me later, not now, because, oh well. But yeah, but I am working on being nicer to myself. One of the things is getting myself to not call myself stupid and to not insult myself so much, which, is difficult because I'm so used to it. Used to saying it. Oh, thank you, phone. Used to saying it, due to the fact that in high school I was very edgy. I did not like myself. I liked myself even less than I do now. And it's kind of like a working process of not being super negative and trying to like at least give myself some good points. Like my good point is the fact that I know how to bake really good cakes. And that makes me really want to bake a cake right now, but I can't because we don't have the ingredients currently, which kind of sucks. But it's nothing to do with me being like anything negative. I was about to say some really negative things again, and I was like, no, don't do that. You're trying not to do that so much. But it's also like working on removing the I hate myself and putting in it is like, I just like myself, but I'm liking myself better. And working on being kinder to myself and being more patient. And like, the funny thing is, I do have patience. I have patience for other people. I have absolutely zero patience for myself because anything I want to do and I don't do, I'm just like, ah, oh, you fucking, and everything like that. And realizing that that's not a great thing to do to myself. Especially with the fact that, like, I'm still, I guess, learning to deal with the fact that I have, mental illnesses and things like that. And, like, I am accepting the fact that I am disabled and realizing that, hey, you know, though I can't do this, that, and the other, I can still do all of these other things. And that's pretty good. Like, I can keep my plants alive very well, even if I can't write a 200-page essay every day to fill out a 2,000-word essay, doesn't mean that I'm dumb. It just means I'm not good at that, and that's fine, and it's just something to learn from. So, yeah, working on it. Another proud thing is that I remembered to be nicer to myself yesterday, and I had two meals. So hell yeah, I did better than I usually do. And it's gonna be like an on and off thing of remembering to do so because I'm bad at that. But it's okay to be bad at things, especially when you can learn from them. And though I'm not learning much, I am learning something. And I don't know what it is yet, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be a positive thing. Lockdown has taught me a lot in the sense that it has shown that I really do not like myself, and I need to work on that heavily. So, working desperately on it, and trying to get myself in a better state of mind so that I am more organized and at least gentler on what I do and realizing that I do have good points rather than being like, oh, you son of a bitch. You just and negative garble, you know. But you know, it's a process and I do have people at least encouraging me and helping me along and like pointing out things that I myself would not recognize at all because, again, I do have myself in a very negative light. But with them, and then the fact that I am taking some medications to deal with it and all of the other things, it's, I think, though 2021 is not gonna be amazing. It's going to be my year of learning for myself to be better to myself, which, you know, it's a thing I didn't expect to have to do. But I think, you know, 2020 really jacked up the standards and has made me realize that I really do need to like be better to myself rather than, you know, having that despair. To the point that, like, everything is a disaster when it shouldn't be, when it could not be, and things like that. So, yeah, it's gonna be fun. And I will also end up having to do a few more Patreon polls, I guess, being like, hey, what should I talk about? Because I don't think you enjoy my rambling. Because I'm pretty sure you didn't like click on the video to hear me talk about the fact that I have really bad depression and anxiety issues, and that my ADHD makes it like absolutely chaos to even remember anything useful to me. So yeah, like I'm pretty sure I'm gonna put those up and be like, hey, what should I talk about while this video is being done, rather than, hey, I'm gonna talk about things. I'm gonna make you feel mildly bad for me when I don't want you to feel bad for me. I want you to feel like, at least happy to like see the video, as well as like, I guess, happy that I'm happy, I guess. I don't know on that part, 'cause like, sometimes it's a weird thing because I don't know if I have much of a relationship with many people, and I'd like to make at least a friendly one and a good association one. And like beyond that, like just have positive impact on people rather than like the negative impact I have on myself. So I'm going back on that, hi, I'm depressed and thank you for coming here. Yeah, it's gonna be an interesting thing and all of that. I'm definitely gonna have to put up polls and be like, hey, what would you like me to talk about? I could jokingly put like, hey, do you want me to like cause discourse? But I won't, because I do not have that type of confidence at all, and I don't want the backlash for any of that if I were to try that. So, that's not an option. But like, do you want me to talk about games and things? And just rather than how I've been, how you've been, everything. This is like really late in the video, but how are you if you've made it this far? How are you? Comment down below and I will answer, because I'm trying to have at least a month space between videos, so I will be answering for at least a week or more, because I know when my video is up and I don't post a lot, and that's the point. It's to have a little bit more of a connection. I could even put a poll for people who know things that are in something I do, for people who don't know what I do, and then is just gonna be hell on wheels, well, hell on a video, to see that. So yeah, also, and in addition, because I am very bad at like keeping order with my thoughts, because I do not have organized thoughts and I will never have organized thoughts. After this college project, that college project becomes an animation project. So therefore, I will have an animation finally up this year, which I'm gonna be really happy about. I'm also gonna mildly dislike, because we're gonna be using Photoshop, and I don't wanna use Photoshop, and I don't wanna learn how to use Photoshop, because nobody knows how to use Photoshop at my college anyway. But if you know anyone who does like a Photoshop like breakdown video of like how to use it and everything, I would absolutely fucking love that, and just send it my way, or just like harass me about it and be like, bro, watch this, bro, watch it, and things like that. Like, hound me. Don't hound me at the same time, because I do get like a little bit bothered by that, but bother me about it in a sense. And God, just it's gonna be a lot of work this year and next year, and I am mildly not looking forward to my second year of the course, but because apparently I will not have time for anything, and I will just, I don't know, cry a lot. So, looking forward to that in some sense of the word. In some sense, but like not full sense, So, That's gonna be fun and everything like that. So here's to hoping. I can't say that 2021 is gonna be great, but I can say it is just one of those years that might not be as bad as the year before. And I'm putting this as might because if I say it will, there's a chance that it will absolutely backfire for everyone saying that. So it might be good. And if not, at least we've learned things. And some of those things will not be things we want to learn. But we learned anyway because I guess fuck us in the polite way, I guess. But anyway, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye!